So in this video, I'm going to begin by narrating the story of DevOps. And the DevOps story is nothing but the story of evolution of an agile enterprise. So let's begin with that. And this story does not begin now or not even in 2009 when DevOps was created. It starts with the turn of the century in around 1915 when Henry Ford introduced the assembly lines. Now, to understand how the car manufacturing and delivery worked before that the companies would build the raw materials, the parts, and they would deliver it to the clients, and they would take the engineers to the client side and have them assemble the cars. Now that was a tedious, a long process, as well as you wouldn't be able to guarantee that all the parts would work with each other. So there was no quality control at that level. And that's what changed with this assembly line. With assembly line, Ford brought the machines to the engineers rather than taking the engineers to the machines, literally. And that changed a whole lot of things for the car manufacturing industry. And that led to the mass production. And assembly line was later on adopted by a lot of manufacturing organizations. Now, as a result or a side effect of this mass production, it also led to overproduction because the companies would just build the products just because they had the raw material, not based on the customer demands really. And that led to a lot of waste. And waste includes a lot of different types of waste. And that's where the significance of Toyota production system comes in. So Toyota started adding or making this assembly line, take it to the next level and make it more efficient. And that's where the contribution of this production engineer from Toyota by name Taichi Ono comes into picture. And this TPS system was evolved over a period of probably, 20 to 30 years, so between 1948 and 1975. Now let's have a look at the TPS system, and what Toyota production system works towards is relentlessly working on eliminating waste from the manufacturing process. What kind of waste? Let's have a look. Waste could be just overproduction, as we just talked about. You just produce things because you have the capacity. It could be waiting. Let's say you have process and your product needs to go through multiple processes, and it's just waiting between two different work centers just for the resources to be available. Could be waste of inventory, waste of transportation, waste in overprocessing. You just keep on overprocessing than it really needs to be. It could be defects. It could be workforce waste and so on and so forth, right? So they identified 8 different types of waste and tried to eliminate the waste from the system to improve the efficiency of the plant. And TPS also introduces some of the interesting concepts which we now adopt in IT industry as well, including just-in-time production. So you produce things not because you have capacity, but you have demand for it. So once the client, asks for the product, you start manufacturing. And if you want to do that, you need to have a lot of automation, a lot of, efficient way of doing things. And a lot of that can be achieved through the pointers and the principles and the practices introduced by TPS. That's just-in-time production. Kanban was also introduced by TPS, and you see this Trello and other board, Kanban boards that we use in the IT organization. Most of the startups use it today, and that's the origin of the Kanban. It also introduces something called as value stream mapping. Let's have a look at that value stream mapping, which is an interesting concept. So what you do with value stream mapping is you look at the information flow as well as the material flows. And if you focus on that material flows for a minute, you see it flows from the raw material, comes from the left-hand side, and the produced material is shipped on the right-hand side. And between that, you have processes 1, 2, 3, that ABC. And what you measure is how much of value it's being added. How long it takes for each work center that to process it. Let's say process A takes about 300 seconds, process B takes 45 seconds, but before it starts processing, there is a 4 days of wait period. And that's what you start measuring, how long it takes for you to get the product out from this complete process left to right. And that's your lead time. Lead time is 14 days, whereas actual processing time is about 585 seconds. So you start optimizing. Once you measure things, you can start optimizing things there, right? And that led to the efficiency, or that started adding efficiency to the manufacturing process. And that's the beginning of the DevOps culture as well. So in this video, we talked about the manufacturing process, the assembly line introduced by Ford, as well as TPS, Toyota Production System, taking it to the next level.